He just wants to separate families. That is a quote from a senior Trump administration official who tells CNN that tonight about President Trump. Multiple sources tell CNN that Trump says he wants to expand his family separation policy. And there's an explicit detail here. He wants to separate families, even if they come to the United States at a legal port of entry. And tonight, his Homeland Security Secretary, Kirstjen Nielsen, is gone. A woman who parroted the president's words, now no longer extreme enough. And there is a purge going on tonight. Trump ousting senior officials fast and furiously. The Secret Service, officials there finding out their boss was ousted today from CNN. The director of the Secret Service is Randa Fallis. Also, of course, Kirstjen Nielsen out, and the would-be head of ICE, Ron Vitiello, who just saw his nomination pulled. And the bloodbath isn't over. Sources tell CNN there are other senior officials whose jobs are on the chopping block this hour, and that means fear, uncertainty, chaos, nothing getting done, and it's getting worse. Jake Tapper tonight also learning of an explosive meeting in the Oval Office two Thursdays ago. The president ordering Nielsen and Secretary of State Mike Pompeo to shut down one of the largest ports of entry into the United States from Mexico. That's the port of El Paso. The president wanted that border closed, and he was explicit in this meeting. He said, I want it closed the next day. That would be, this meeting was on a Thursday. Tomorrow, Friday at noon, I want it closed. According to a person in that room, the president was ranting and raving as he said this. Nielsen warning him that closing ports was a bad and dangerous idea. And again, tonight she's gone. So let's be clear. Someone who said these things was not extreme enough when push came to shove for President Trump.
Let me be clear. Walls work.
Yes or no, are we still putting children in cages?
To my knowledge, CBP never purposely put a child in a cage, if you mean a cage like this.
Are you intending for this to play out as it is playing out? Are you intending for parents to be separated from their children? Are you intending to send a message?
I find that offensive.
Caitlin Collins is out front live outside the White House. And Caitlin, look, you have this breaking news on the president wanting to expand the family separation policy, this purge going on. And the big question is, of course, who's helping the president? Who's aiding and abetting him in engineering this?
Well, as far as Nielsen's ouster, Stephen Miller certainly played a pretty critical role in that. He often complained about Nielsen to Trump with President Trump, and President Trump held her responsible for that recent spike in illegal immigration crossings down at the border. So, but it wasn't just her. She kind of was on an island in the West Wing, essentially, because she butted heads with the chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney. She didn't get along with the national security advisor, John Bolton, and she also wasn't on close terms with Jared Kushner either, all people who the president values their opinion greatly. So essentially, she was alone and had few, if any, allies left in the West Wing to defend her when the president was holding her responsible for immigration problems.
So you have, as you say, Stephen Miller obviously playing a more and more central role. Obviously, his views on immigration are extreme. And obviously, he's one of the youngest members also of this White House, what, 31, 32 years old. This comes as the president also wants the current Commissioner of Customs and Border Protection, Kevin McAleenan, to take over as the acting Homeland Security Secretary. What should that name mean to people watching, Caitlin? What's his relationship with the president?
Well, that's interesting because there was already someone in line to take over if Nielsen ever left. That's Claire Grady. She's the acting deputy secretary right now. But instead, the president has picked the commissioner of Customs and Border Protection, someone he does not have a great relationship with. They don't know each other well, I'm told by several sources, though he did travel with President Trump to the border last week. I'm told that President Trump started to notice him after McAleenan held this press conference where he said that essentially immigration enforcement was at a breaking point because of the recent surge in migrant families trying to cross the border. Now, he also has some fans in the West Wing, especially in Jared Kushner. Two people say that Jared Kushner likes McAleenan a lot. But, Erin, the question is going to be here, the laws on immigration are not changing immediately. The president can't change them the way that he's been able to fire the people that have been ousted in recent days. And Kevin McAleenan is not seen as some ideologue, some hardliner who's going to be taking over. They say essentially they think he'll run things the way Nielsen was running things. So that's the question. Does anything actually change? And what is the president's response to that? And how does he hold McAleenan responsible? Now, we should note McAleenan's going to be there in an acting position. The president hasn't nominated him to be the permanent secretary where he'd have to go through the confirmation process. So it's kind of going to be one of those wait and see things. The president will see if he likes the job he's doing.
All right. Thank you very much, Caitlin. And I want to go straight now to the chairman of the Homeland Security Committee, Democratic Congressman Benny Thompson. Congressman, I appreciate your time. So let's just start with, obviously, you know, we're learning about these, the ranting and raving, these meetings, a policy the president wanted to expand. Stephen Miller, obviously, we are learning quite central to all of this. What do you think about his influence over the president right now? We're talking, of course, about 33-year-old Stephen Miller, who was one of crucial in the travel ban, and obviously a huge advocate of separating families at the border.
Well, it's nice to have young people around, but it's also nice to have people around who get it. These extreme views that Mr. Miller puts forth are not who we are as Americans. So I think what we have to do is to say to the president, Mr. President, we are a nation of laws. Our laws are clear with respect to immigration. Anytime you try to make those laws out to be something than other than what they are, then you exactly have the chaos that we're having along the border now.
So when we're reporting tonight that the president wants to expand the separating families at the border, and in fact, he wants to do that to families that come in at legal ports of entry, families seeking asylum. Do you think he has the right to do that, Chairman?
Well, absolutely. You know, this family separation issue is what really brought all the conflict and chaos at the border to the forefront. The president has to follow the law. No one is above the law. The courts have determined that many of the policies he's trying to implement are absolutely illegal. The return to Mexico policy, the Muslim travel ban that he tried. A lot of things that we are involved in is simply because the president wants to have his way.
Do you think it's black and white on separating families?
Oh, no question about it. Why in on God's green earth would we separate children from their families? We are a better country than that. And so to separate them and then not know where the parents are, in many instances, we don't know who the children are. And so what I say to this administration, we have to get it right. You're doing absolute harm, not to just the people who are trying to get here, but to the value of what America means to the rest of the world.
Now, obviously, this is something that when the president started doing it was roundly criticized on both sides of the aisle. Now we're hearing that what he's saying in some of these meetings, which have been so tumultuous and explosive, where he's been ranting and raving, is that he thinks it works. It will deter people from coming to the United States if you separate families. Obviously,
well, if you look at the statistics, it's having the opposite effect. And so what we have to do is to say, look, you can't cut off the State Department monies to the Northern Triangle countries. You can't meter people who are coming to the border. You can't have the return to Mexico policy. All these things have been created by this administration. This zero tolerance thing, putting children in cages. All these things go against who we are as Americans. Our system of values is more than just that.
So you do have some Republicans speaking out tonight. Chairman of the Senate Homeland Security Committee, your colleague, Republican Senator Ron Johnson, says, I'm concerned with the growing leadership void within the department tasked with addressing some of the most significant problems facing the nation, referring, of course, to Nielsen. John Cornyn telling CNN also today, quote, losing senior leadership at these important positions, that's bound to make the president and the administration's jobs harder, not easier. Is this enough, or is this all talk and no action from your Republican colleagues?
Well, principally, no, all talk and no action. I'm surprised that they're saying anything. All the things that have occurred up to this point that has happened to children and all of that, most of my colleagues have been quiet. You can't run a department with over 220,000 employees with part-time leadership. And now you're trying to put people in office that probably violate the law that Congress passed. So the president has to follow the law. If he wants to talk to Democrats, come talk to us. You don't have to tweet us. You can just come right to Capitol Hill and we'll talk to you.
I'm wondering what you think, though. Look, you've said that Kirstjen Nielsen was unable to lead and stand up to the president for his misguided, wall-obsessed anti-immigrant agenda. That's a quote from you. But we're learning that Nielsen, despite all the times, which I showed, and there's many more of them, right, where she said exactly what he wanted her to say when he wanted her to say it, she did push back at the president in these meetings. She said the law wouldn't allow it. Now, maybe she might try to find workarounds within the law, but she wanted to stay with the rule of law. She's gone. What if her replacement, her full replacement, when there is one, doesn't even try to cite the law? Could this get worse, in your opinion?
Well, there's no question. He's trying to find a puppet to run the Department of Homeland Security. We have to have professionals. We are a nation of laws. So to put anybody other than a professional in that position is doing a disservice to the men and women who put their lives on the line every day. So I say to the president, don't send us a puppet to run the Department of Homeland Security. Send us a professional.
All right. Thank you very much, Chairman. I appreciate your time tonight.